Welcome to the SIXSENSE Foundation. Oxygen filling, cycle complete.
People don't use our music to get high. They use our music to get by.
Operating under the crooked American system too long. Outcast, pronounced outcast. Adjective meaning homeless or unaccepted in society. But let's look deeper than that. Are you an outcast? If you understand and feel the basic principles and fundamental truths contained within this music, you probably are. If you think it's all about pimping hoes and slamming Cadillac doors, you probably a cracker. Or a nigga that think he a cracker. Or maybe just don't understand. An outcast is someone who is not considered to be part of the normal world. He's looked at differently. He's not accepted because of his clothes, his hair, his occupation, his beliefs, or his skin color. Now look at yourself. Are you an outcast? I know I am. As a matter of fact, fuck being anything else. It's only so much time left in this crazy world. Wake up, niggas, and realize what's going on around you. Poisoning of the food and water, tampering of cigarettes, disease engineering control over your life. Take back your existence or die like a punk. This is Big Rube saying right on to the real, death to the fake.
I made a name for myself, telling truth over tracks. Devils hate the way I elevate the youth and the blacks. Never hold back shit, life's cold as a bitch. I'm gonna live it, then reveal it, you can roll or dismiss. See, I'ma told you like this, you hold your goals in your fist. If you can grasp it, you can gas it up and go on a trip. Or you can just be a blip, wreck and total your ship. And have some stories for your kids when you get old with a limp. See, whatever you do, you gotta do that smart. You say you're true to get the loot, let's see if you got hard. Like Pippin said, let them haters do their job. Or you can lay it down and die to prove that you ain't hard. I ain't the one to cop block when you do the thing. You wanna ride, drop top, maybe blow out the brain. Drop $1 million bling when you gripping the grain. But you a slave if you working for a whip and a chain. You think that money can't stop, you ain't using your brain. Be a fiend for the green and things are subject to change. 100,000 on your throat, 200 more on the frame. But you a slave cause you working for a whip and a chain. Design your life on the dot and give them total control. You think you're nice, but you're not. You sold your body and soul. Learn a lesson, it's a blessing when you get that chance. Fast women, fast cars, even faster advance. You spend out, the rich bout to be, you on the first. You realize this shit is real, but was you real with the first? See the real changes, niggas, when they sticking together. And the real whip is how they get that paper forever. But it's worth it cause your life will be enriched for the best. Especially if you never have to take a clip to the chest. Niggas get put to the test, cause it get put to the best. So I'ma pass it with a classic till they put me to rest. I ain't the one to cop block when you do the thing. You wanna ride, drop top, maybe blow out the brain. Drop $1 million bling when you gripping the brain. But you a slave if you working for a whip and a chain. You think that money can't stop, you ain't using your brain. Be a fiend for the green and things are subject to change. 100,000 on your throat, 200 more on the frame. But you a slave cause you working for a whip and a chain. I'm legendary, not for cheddar, whips, chains, or the bras. I said death to the fake, how many answered the call? Of real niggas, feel niggas, ain't no taming us all. I felt the pain, been through the changes, now these lanes finna fall. Coming dungeon, running, gunning, stunning, hundreds of y'all. Couldn't take me down if I was dying, cause ain't none of me flaw. You best to learn to see the signs and understand what you saw. See me, I represent that science, Mr. Sun is my boy. The real Leonard McCoy, folk ain't no choosing this life. I gotta win it, so I in it, make this music my wife. For every minute that I'm in it, wanna live it again. The money might be gone tomorrow, but the love never ends. Ain't the one to cop block when you doing your thing. You wanna ride, drop top, maybe blow out the brain. Drop $1 million bling when you gripping the grain. But you a slave if you working for a whip and a chain. You think that money can't stop, you ain't using your brain. Be a fiend for the green and things are subject to change. 100,000 on your throat, 200 more on the frame. But you a slave cause you working for a whip and a chain.
Whip and a chain, whip and a chain. You a slave if you working for a whip and a chain. Whip and a chain, whip in the chain. You a slave, you working for a whip in the chain.
Would you like to know more?
Outside the world famous Apache Cafe. Y'all know what it is. Hollering at my man Big Rube, what's good? DF, DE on this side. Dungeonezze, baby. Yeah, Big Rube. But I had to speak from a, what's happening, brother? I had to speak from a fan's perspective because I haven't been part of the fam too long. But, you know, when I go back to that first Outkast album, man, it captured me. You know what I mean? From day one, yeah. Man, from the first time I heard his voice. I look at Big Rube, man, as being like the offensive coordinator, you know what I'm saying, on the football team. And not even the one on the field, you know what I mean? I'm talking about the one that be up in the booth. You know, you really don't see him, but you hear from him, and he overseeing the game. So that's how I look at it, man, and that's the relationship that I built with him so far. So good brother, man. Words really can't describe what he's done for the foundation of the South and the mentality of the brothers down here, man. So just wanted to put my two cents in. Y'all get at me. Get on the track, Rube. I got a beat for you. You already know what it is. Holler back at your boy, Jaws. Peace.
Rube. The reason Rube ain't got no album out, straight up, is because, I mean, ain't did his movie, ain't did his album yet, because the weight behind, and I'm gonna use this word weight in three references. Weight as in we're looking forward to something, and weight as in his depth and his physical load on the industry and hip hop as a whole, and then Atlanta. And then weight, like, fuck that, it's only two. So. The two weights we're talking about with Rube. The reason we're waiting on his album is because the time had to change so that Rube could be understood. Because, you know, what we do is an organized noise, we try to think in the future as far as producing. You can't produce some shit for now, thinking now. You gotta produce for now, thinking next year. You feel me? So that by the time that it comes out, and all of that comes back around, you will be fresh and you won't be old. Because if I do what's going on now and expect it to hit in 7 months by the time it comes out, I'm a fool. The game has changed too quick. So thus, we stay in the future with it. So Big Rube and the whole Organized Noise movement, like, Rube is so far in the future with what we was talking about. Like, niggas still ain't got what the fuck the nigga said on Southern Playlistic. At the end of the record, the nigga said, if you think it's all about slamming Cadillac doors and pimping hoes, you a cracker or a nigga who think he a cracker. The only part out of that niggas got was slamming Cadillac doors and pimping hoes. That's all they got out of that. They didn't hear any other words, you know what I'm saying? So it's like the time it takes for that to settle in, the words in between, the pimping hoes and the slamming Cadillac doors, the time it takes for all that to settle in is the time that we've been waiting on his album. And now it's overdue, and now it's time for it to come forth. And it'll be birthed, just like how in the Bible, in the book of Revelations, it says a woman should be pregnant with a child, and the beast shall come after this child, but the Most High shall have the child caught up in the spirit, and it shall be hidden in the wilderness, and a place shall be prepared for it until time. So look at it like that, as prophecy, that what we bring forth now with the future, with SWAT Day and the whole movement again behind Big Rube, you know what I'm saying, as a leader, as an emissary of the truth, is that we not waiting no more. What you want me to say?
I was born to be king by my own hand, but the crown weighs heavily upon the brow. As we laid out our legacies before you, judgment was imminent, but honor is a force for you. For my words are my sword, and the truth is my shield. No excuses when you arm it with my skin tone. Repping dungeon to the bone, I'll forever be a dragon, breathing fire just to keep your thoughts heated up. Made you eat it up from the first bite. With the first mic grab, we put the South on another level. Raised Atlanta from the ashes like a phoenix. Now we soar free, destination anywhere we wanna go. Everything I ever dreamed in my grasp, fame, money, and respect, I swear this music is my passion. Organized noise from the concrete, playalistic brain, food rituals, and darkness came the greatest hits. Legendary shit.
The legend lives on.
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 I said who? Country boys. Nappy Roots, the barnyard's baddest. Boy, I'm wild.
hair blocks down. I still read on that loud. All my life.
I know Ceelo doing my own album. You know what I'm saying? You killing them worldwide.
I'm proud of you, you know what I mean, man? Congratulations, dog. Shit,
congratulations.
Long time coming long overdue, big fella.
Shit, well, you know, I just wanted to come out and holler at you. You know, you one of my brothers from the original crew. And I definitely wanted to, you know, just get you on the DVD. Just, you know, get some of your thoughts, maybe, you know what I'm saying? See what you had to say about, just, you know, however we got, you know, started, or however you want to kick it, you know, what you think about me doing the project, you know what I'm saying?
Okay. Long story. you know me, man, I credit all things that have transpired, man, like, you know, to nothing less than divinity, you know what I mean? You know, so the common cause and common bond was music, you know, but not music to solely entertain, but to uplift and empower. And so, like, and I consider the Dungeon family, you know, and our collective accomplishments as activism. I mean, like, so more than we were entertainers or MCs or poets, you know, like, we were activists, you know, so like fighting for the civil rights, you know, so like of Southern hip hop and music right. as a whole, you know. And I say, what is it now? You know, almost 14 years later, you know what I mean? We are seeing the fruits of our labor, you know what I mean? You know, and so, right. like the forefathers, you know, so like of Southern music, I must say, like in addition to the likes of, you know, rap a lot, you know, so Jay Prince and, you know, Ghetto Boys, and of course, Luke Skywalker, you know, Miami and Jermaine Dupri is so definitely. As far as Dungeon Family is concerned, as far as Big Rube is concerned, like Big Rube was a pillar, you know what I'm saying? Like as far as Dungeon Family was concerned, like we all sat around, like, you know, like and humbled ourselves in the presence of Big Rube and his knowledgeability, you know, so like about whatever the case may have been, you know, and you know, so we all slept on the floor in the dungeon, you know what I'm saying? I guess 13, 14, 15 of us over there, like all night sessions, you know, like we really lived together, we really were a band of brothers, and as far as Rube doing a record, man, like, you know, I just had never, you know, seen him be able to be consolidated, you know, so like within the confines of a song, being that your, you know, your vocabulary and just understanding was just so vast, and you know, so like it's so like to see you, you know, to do that and put that into a process, man, like, you know, saying into a body of work, man, like is you know, quite a, like a sight to see, like I'm saying, to hear, of course. I mean, like, so, you know, you got my undivided attention and, you know, my, you know, unconditional love, homie, and support, like if we ever need, like we here today, like it is nothing, you know what I'm saying?
Right, thank you. I appreciate it too.
Oh, for sure.
Know that. You know.
Any funny stories or anything candid or any, just anything? It ain't gotta be formal. You know what I'm saying? Like, cause hey, yeah, I'm telling you, I wouldn't got everybody, and everybody from the dungeon has something crazy to say.
Funny story. I got a funny story, but I ain't gonna say it.
Okay.
Yeah. I think Rube might know what I'm talking about.
I might know what you're talking about. I'll
tell you one thing, though. Look at this tattoo right here. See this here? Now, this is my Rube. This is the one who I know as well. Dynamic, you know what I mean? Like, just what I got to describe, and that's all true. So, like, just what this tattoo describes in the same way, it's also just the truth. And this particular 9mm pistol right here, I took Rube to the East Point pawn shop and bought this pistol.
Yep.
Damn sure did. That's a good story.
That exact pistol. Damn sure did.
Yo, ain't nothing wrong with talking when you got something to say. A lot of these motherfuckers around here running their mouth. Just running their mouth, but their brain ain't running shit. Shut the fuck up, bitch nigga. I'm tired of y'all motherfuckers around here talking out of here and shit. You keep motherfucking talking, I'ma slap the goddamn shit out one of y'all motherfuckers. Punk ass, bitch ass, fuck ass, sis ass, puss ass nigga. Keep talking out of that shit. Shut the fuck up or I smack that piss ass.
Then set your ass up before I slap you. Then set your ass up before I slap you. Then set your ass up before I slap you. Then set your ass up, boy.
Hey, niggas wanna hang, get smacked in the face.
Okay. Get light, man.
Alright. This is what's up.
You got the DVD.
I'm gonna say it like this. When I first started coming down here, I was like 16. You know, my cousin, hanging out with them, going to the studio, talking to Rube. You know what I'm saying? What talking to Rube did for me was show me how to expand my mind in a new direction. You know what I'm saying? So I always appreciate him for that. And you know what I'm saying? I probably wouldn't be who I am right now if it wasn't for, you know, him and a lot of other people that, you know, I was introduced to when I came to Atlanta. So just want to say what's up with that. And other than that, you know, SWAT day all along. I'm all day LA, California, ATLian. So, kid, Dungeonese.
Nah, we in Stankonia right now, owned by Outkast. So the player listed.
Tired of ignorance, niggas wouldn't kill each other if they had a SIXSENSE.
A SIXSENSE?
A SIXSENSE.
I've got one of those, a SIXSENSE between your eyes, your ears, your nose.
I've been telling folks for years.